I'm Sin with the Osen Dojo, and in this video, I'm going to walk through the Osen portion of the 2023 DEF CON Hackman game. The Osen Dojo was asked to create the Osen portion for this year's game. And now that it's over, I'm going to show you how to solve each of these individual challenges. For those not familiar with the game, it is similar to the classic Pac-Man arcade game. You use your mouse or arrow buttons to navigate a character throughout the maze. What's different is that there are multiple categories, each with their own submazes. Eating a power pellet and then a ghost will bring up a question that you need to answer before you're able to move forward in the maze. For our first challenge, we need to investigate a Craigslist scam, and we are provided with two links to images containing additional information. We're then asked to determine what day of the week the scammer posted their ad. Opening up the two images, we are presented with an email from a scam victim, as well as a screenshot attachment of the original ad. Since the screenshot includes the URL, we're going to start there. I'm going to upload the photo into Google Lens and then simply copy the text from the URL bar. Unfortunately, if we go to that link, we can see that the ad is no longer available. Instead, we can navigate to the Wayback Machine and find an archived copy. The posted time here at the top of our ad gives us the timestamp that we're looking for. We can then cross-check this date against the calendar on the previous page and confirm that the scammer posted the ad on a Friday. For our second challenge, we're asked to identify the email address that the scammer included in their ad. This is as simple as going back to the archive page, where we can find the email spelled out as coinopcrony@proton.me. Question 3 then asks us to take this email address and then determine the date that it was created. We can obtain this by running the CLI tool, Protocent, and supplying it with our target email. For this challenge, we did not create any additional keys for this account, and so the public key referenced here is the original one automatically generated during the account creation process. Continuing on to challenge 4, we're asked to pivot off the email address to the scammer's Reddit username. To answer this, we're going to search the email on the MIT PGP key server. Our results show that there is an additional PGP key associated to our scammer email. When creating the key, they also provided the username of xxarcadearturoxx. Checking this on Reddit, we can confirm that this is the correct username. Now we're asked to identify the fraudster's Tumblr username. This one is very straightforward, as the scammer actually linked their Tumblr profile in the Reddit biography section here on the right. The username also follows a similar format to their Reddit username. Moving on to challenge 6, we now need to geolocate the store where the scammer was on May 29th. Afterwards, we need to identify the English nickname of one of the characters on the outside of the storefront. Scrolling through the Tumblr profile, there are only a few available posts, none of which match what we're looking for, and we have no way to navigate to the next page. This is because the user leveraged a custom layout which hides this functionality. Despite this, we can manually add /archive to the end of the URL and view the other posts. Viewing the full-size image, we can see that the text appears to be in Japanese, which does give us a bit of a clue. Running the image through Google Lens provides us results for a gaming store in Tokyo called Super Potato. If we search for Super Potato Tokyo, we see an image of their Akihabara building where we can see 4 pixel characters on the outside. We need to identify the nickname for the Pac-Man ghost on the far left. A quick check of the wiki tells us that the cyan ghost's English nickname is Inky. Now, on challenge 7, we need to identify the real name of our scammer. To do so, we need to go back to the photos included in the original Craigslist ad. The scammer used their resume as a backdrop when they were photographing their arcade tokens for the original ad. We want to take the full-size photo and bring it to an editing software such as GIMP. From here, we'll flip the image and adjust the shadows and highlights to make the name easier for us to read. Although we already know our scammer goes by Arturo, this resume actually gives us his last name as well, which is Dempsey. Next, we need to identify where our scammer was previously employed as a game technician. Once again, we'll go back to one of the images in the original Craigslist ad, and then we're going to apply the same techniques that we previously used to manipulate the last photo. Afterwards, we're also going to adjust the brightness and contrast to help us better read the text. We can read the game technician title, however, the business name is not immediately clear. If we go to Google, we can enter in an educated guess, and we're actually given the correct answer of the arcade, Ground Control. Challenge 9 asks us to find the BSS ID of the scammer's previous employer. This is as simple as taking the address for Ground Control and dropping it into Wiggle while logged in. Now that the door is unlocked, we have just one final challenge to complete the OSINT section. For our final flag, we need to identify which street artist previously had artwork where our scammer took a photograph. We're going to go back to the scammer's Tumblr page and identify the post which occurred on the correct date. From here, we need to open the full-size image. We once again see Japanese text, but also the English restaurant name of Le Maghreb over on the left. A Google search for Le Maghreb Japan brings us to a TripAdvisor page where we can find a link to the location within Google Maps. Zooming in, and then dropping down to Street View, confirms that this is the same location as the Tumblr photograph. We'll move back to approximately the same area where the initial photo was taken, and then click on a previous date to try and identify the missing artwork. We can see 3 different pieces of street art. The blue one at the top, Death graffiti underneath it, and then another graffiti tag here on the right. If we swap to a newer date, we can see that the blue one is the only one that's currently missing. I'll once again switch to a different date to find a better image of this artwork. We'll then run it through Yandex's reverse image search. This will return results which include the answer, a French artist named Invader, who is also known for their pixel-style tile art, like the one in our photo.